And we all know there's something wrong with that, but we don't know how to get out. Right? Is that your question, or did it lead into?
I think so. My daughter is very young. She's
yes.
19 days old, and she was looking at me, and she doesn't have any expression in her eyes of anger or anything like that.
No, because she's 19 days old.
Right. She was looking at me, and I felt
rage.
Fear, and I felt anger.
Towards the baby?
Yeah, towards, not towards the baby so much as towards those eyes that just didn't have anger or anything in them.
Ah, innocence.
Yeah, she's innocent.
That's
and what I'm so afraid of.
That's how liberals feel towards Colonel North.
Yeah.
I don't know, I don't feel that way toward him.
They're frothing in the mouth because he's innocent. He's got more than, there's a difference between naivete, which is a baby, sort of innocent, but it hasn't a chance to be guilty yet.
Right.
But the point is, it's more innocent than we are.
Yes.
And there's something not disturbed as we are.
Yes.
And there's something coming through that little baby that we can't put our finger on it, because the mind is not so muddied that some light isn't coming through the child.
And see? I'm so afraid.
It's closer to God than we are.
Yes.
And it's making the darkness in us hateful.
Yeah, and I'm afraid.
Go on.
I'm worried, afraid about
out with it.
About hurting the baby, making her sin, making her.
In other words, you don't want her to be there. You feel threatened by the purity.
No, I do, but I don't want to make her impure.
There's two of you in there.
Yeah.
There's the you, and that doesn't want to be that way. That acknowledges that you are that way.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
There's two of you in there.
Okay.
And which one's going to win?
That's what I don't know.
Do you understand that someone did that to you? Do you understand you're a victim of someone who didn't want you to, that once upon a time you had eyes like that?
Yeah.
That you were more innocent and they couldn't stand it.
And
they destroyed that somehow.
Yeah.
And that's what's in you now, glaring at this little baby, innocent child.
Yeah.
And that's the way it is in our society. What you're looking at now is, what have I said in the last program? Is that we have to look at that. Now you may not have seen that before, that many women do not see this about themselves. They just feel angry with their child and feel like, well, that's why it's normal. You know, the kid does wrong and we're angry. Well, what's a parent, how else is a parent to be? My parents were angry with me. They don't see anything wrong with that.
But she doesn't.
They see
do
nothing
wrong
with projecting.
She doesn't do wrong.
She doesn't do wrong, but she will do wrong if you keep being impatient with her.
And I wasn't impatient
if she senses that inside you glaring at her. She feels what you feel.
She
feels your emotions. So what you, she's bonded to you in some way. She feels it in the touch.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Of course, there's every reason to be. Now look, I just explained to you something. Just a few minutes ago, before we went on the program, I was talking to Bill, my producer, and we got on the subject of intimidation and fear. And I said there's two types of resentment. One of them is called impatience. And one of them is called resentment. Now, for all intents and purposes, they do appear to be the same. But they're not. One is the superior form of the superior form, the part of the hatred of good that tempts and is the tempter. The intimidator. And then there's the intimidated, the one who responds to impatience with resentment. Now, the one that responds is the victim. The one who causes the response with impatience is like the mother you used to have. What you're talking about is your mother's inside you. She was impatient with you, and she destroyed you because she then, this loveless state called impatience, through patience possess ye your soul. Through impatience, you lose it.
This sounds like a stupid question.
Yeah? You understand? Who understands what I'm saying now?
I do.
Good.
This sounds like a stupid question, but I was adopted. So is it a hereditary thing or an environment?
No, it's not hereditary. It could have been something you felt, you know, your real mother must have rejected you.
I guess.
See, but about your adoptive mother, parent, they might have some bearing on that too.
Yes, I think
because
so.
You look like to me, I mean, I don't mean to be rude, but you look psychotic.
What
you
does
look
that mean?
Not psychotic meaning wimpy.
Yeah.
Weak. If I was a mugger, I'd pick on you real easy.
Yes,
you'd be an easy target. Yes. You'd submit. And someone, it's written all over your face. Everybody sitting in this room, like, you can almost tell what people are like by taking their physical form. Because what you are inside begins to show on your face and your features and the way you sit, the way you carry yourself. It is you. Cowardly, bully, redneck. See? Or a cowardly, because a redneck is a bully too, because he's a bullier. He's been bullied into being the very thing he hates. But inside there's a coward. But now, coming back to that, we are weak before the strong, and we've been conditioned to take our identity from reacting resentfully to impatient people. Who's following that? See? And these impatient people become the authority, because impatience is wickedness. Patience is love. If you're patient, you don't feel love flowing through you. You don't feel love flowing through you when you're patient. No. When somebody flips you off on the freeway, let's come back to that. See, you don't feel love flowing through you. See, you just don't have a reaction. When that little baby looks up in your eyes, you don't feel impatience. You don't cause the response, nor are you a respondee, a person who does the responding. Either one of you are, not right. Patience is the evidence that you have found faith. You have found something greater than what's in the world. And then this patience keeps you from responding and taking your identity from the environmental authorities. The authorities you love because you can't admit you're inferior. Many people bow and scrape, you see, to authority because they can't admit to being inferior. They can't live with them, they can't live without them, you know. They can't admit to that. They can't admit their slavishness is what it is, slavishness. In the light of their inner reality, they won't look at it. They're too prideful. So what they do is they worship what has created them, a slave. And they try to make the person who enslaves them, who's created them, try to get them to say that this slavishness is not really slavishness at all, but love, to get approval for their slavish behavior. That way they don't have to see that it's slavishness. They can think that it's greater love for the tyrant.
Do you?
See? And they're living out of that approval. They're living out of the tyrant, aren't they? Living to please the tyrant, to have this delusion, you know, validated. Am I making sense? I don't mean to be jumping all around here, but you've got to have patience for your child. And this impatience in your child, you're looking at your mother, your mentors. You're seeing yourself as the tormentor, you're seeing the great evil inside you now. It's evil coming through. Look, just let me dissect this if I may. Patience is only possible If I tempt you to hate me and you don't respond. What kind of person are you that I can slap you in the face, I can call you all kinds of cruel things, take your money, you know, break your arm, and you don't hate me for it? That's what I want to see. I want to see you hate me. I want to see you respond to me. I want to see, because that way I'm in charge. I'm the power. See, I'm going to be impatient to make you think there's something wrong with you. All authorities are impatient. That way they project the idea there's something wrong with you, and you get to think there's something wrong with you because you resent them, their lack of love. See, because all impatient people get their power from the world around them. They don't get the power from within. They get the power from without. See? And they get their power from without by people falling, being tempted, intimidating, but the secret is impatience. And therefore they absorb your energy. They project an identity, but they take your life. There's an exchange going on. You follow that? So that when you get impatient with your child, what'll happen is you'll get between the child's love of what's right and the ground of the child's being, so he grows to serve the father in love and life, grows up to be a patient, strong, noble being. But you get between that because that child doesn't serve the kingdom of your hell inside. He won't serve that if a child is calm and doesn't respond. He won't give up energy. He won't give up worship. He won't give up his life. You can't create a member of the kingdom, because you're going to create something that needs you, that responds to you. You need more and more of those if you're a dictator. But that's why women have children. They want power, not because they love their children.
If
yes, there's a lady over here. Just go ahead.
If